Hi guys, it's Jag here from Jag Aquatics and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today's video is really special because I'm starting on a new series of videos which will be covering all the nutrients required for growing your aquarium plants. We will go through each and every element that is required for aquarium plants, and in this video we will cover the first element, which is nitrogen. What we will cover is why nitrogen is important for aquatic plants, sources of nitrogen in your aquarium, different deficiencies of nitrogen that can be seen in plants, what is the optimum level of nitrates in your tank, why limiting nitrates make plant red. It's pretty hot topic nowadays, so we'll discuss that, and at the end how to fix nitrogen deficiency in your aquarium. So aquatic plants nutrients are divided into two major categories, macro and micro. So macro are the nutrients that are required in abundance or in much bigger quantities than the micronutrients. And macronutrients can be further divided into primary and secondary macronutrients, where primary macronutrients are required in much larger quantity than the secondary micronutrients. So primary macronutrients consist of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. And on the other hand, secondary macronutrients consist of sulfur, calcium, and magnesium. And micronutrients consist of iron, manganese, copper, molybdenum, cobalt, boron, and zinc. And in this video we will be covering in detail only one element, and that's nitrogen. So before we jump into a discussion of nitrogen, I just want to mention that I will be using terms nitrogen and nitrates throughout my video. Basically, why I will use nitrates is because we supply nitrogen in the aquarium in the form of nitrates. So let's start on the first question: why nitrogen is important for aquatic plants. Nitrogen is one of the main elements which is found in abundance in plant tissue after carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. And if you guys check the plant's dry mass, you will know that carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen makes a massive 95% of a plant's dry mass. Also, the other big thing is that nitrogen is really helpful in the formation of chlorophyll. We all know chlorophyll is a green pigment in plant that uses the light energy, carbon dioxide, and water to create plant food. Now, you all guys must have studied either in your school, or if you are a young follower of this channel, you might be studying in a school in your science classes that this is the process how the plants make food, and it's called photosynthesis. Now, that's the whole reason why nitrogen is really important for plants, because it helps to provide food to the plant. And most of the time, plants absorb nitrogen in aquariums in a form of nitrates. So now the next question arises is, what are different sources of nitrogen in your aquarium, or how we can add more nitrogen in your aquarium? One is the natural source, which is happening because of the decay of the uneaten food, plant decay, or the fish waste. So all that converts into ammonia. And we all know when we start a new tank, we should cycle the tank. So why the whole emphasis is always on cycling the tank is because if you cycle a tank, it means that your nitrogen life cycle have kick-started. It will convert the dangerous levels of ammonia into nitrite, and then nitrifying bacteria in the aquarium will convert nitrate to nitrates. And nitrates at low level is not toxic. So what we are talking is, if your nitrates are above 40 ppm, definitely you should go and change water. But if they are below 40 ppm, it's mostly okay. I would like to prefer around 20 to 30 ppm. But if you have plants in your tank, they love nitrate, and they will use that nitrates to grow. Now, the other way to provide nitrates or nitrogen in your tank is to use the off-the-shelf fertilizers. If your tank is really super clean, there's not much decay happening, then it means your nitrogen levels definitely will be pretty low. So what you can do is you can use off the shelf fertilizers, and you can use nitrogen from there and provide that food to your aquarium plants. So now let's look into how we can identify nitrogen deficiencies in your aquarium. So if your nitrogen levels are really low, by that I mean is around 0 ppm, or you know, you pretty much don't have any fish waste or less livestock, no food waste. So what you will see is that your plants are really growing slow, or they are not growing at all. Also, what you will see, like shown in this picture, there will be overall yellowing of the plant. So leaves will get yellow, especially the older leaves will turn yellow and translucent on the leaf tip, and the whole leaf can turn translucent. Also, what you will see that older leaves will get bad and the new leaves or new growth is small and crippled. And also sometimes very low levels of nitrate can cause blue-green algae, which can be seen especially on the tips of nitrate-hungry plants. I've seen that quite often. So these are the few of the deficiencies that you can see in your aquarium. Okay, now let's discuss what are the different optimum levels of nitrate. I know this question is being discussed a lot nowadays because there's quite a variation. Some people say that, you know, around 30 ppm is the best. Some say 20, some say below 10. So according to me, in my experience, if you want to be on the safe side, 10 to 20 ppm is pretty good. Under that range, what I experience is that you will never find nitrogen deficiency easily. And also everything in tanks looks nice and green and the plants grow really fast. But saying that, if you want to make your tank look really vibrant red colored or red coloration in your tank, and especially in plants like Rotala colorata or Ludwigia arcuata, then what you can do is lower the nitrate levels to around 5 to 10 ppm and even at 0 to 5 ppm. So what happens is when you lower to these levels, you will see that your tank will show more red, more vibrant red in these type of plants, which normally look greenish or yellowish in color. Nowadays, this technique is really famous in, you know, modern aquascapers if you want to achieve that dense growth and the really vibrant growth for the aquascaping comp. Also, what lower levels of nitrate does is that it gives you a compact growth and the node distance in the plant is reduced also. And this is what is called lean style of fertilizing, and it's preferred nowadays. There are a few pictures below that show all the vibrant colors. So what I have done here is we use the Jag Aquatic fertilizers, but they are not super lean. They will maintain the levels around 5 to 10 ppm. And that's how I can achieve these kind of colors here. So why limiting nitrates in your tank make plant red? You all know that nitrogen is really important to manufacture chlorophyll. And when we limit nitrates, it means nitrogen is limited. And what that does is that delays the production of chlorophyll, which is a green pigment in plants. And the result of that is that the plants that used to look more yellowish green will start looking more orange or red. Now, this is exactly what lean dosing is doing. It's hitting the right levels of nitrates to achieve that vibrant color. But when you're using lean dosing, make sure that you monitor your nitrates carefully, because it's like living on the edge. You can achieve the best possible results, but you are in a risk of reducing your levels too low, and you know, you will see more deficiency in your tank. And that's why most of the fertilizing companies, they recommend 10 to 20 ppm of nitrate levels. Now the next question is how we can fix this nitrogen deficiency in your aquarium. There are a few different ways to do that. You can add liquid fertilizers. Now liquid fertilizers are available in market in different styles. There's all-in-one, which is really popular, where you have one bottle and it has everything in it and you can dose it a few times a week. Or there is macro and micro style, where you have macro elements and micro elements in different bottles and you can dose them on separate or alternate days. Or you can get an individual element, like you can get a nitrogen in a separate bottle in a form of nitrates, and you can dose that. Also, there are different styles of fertilizers in the market according to lean fertilizing or rich fertilizing or a mix of both, where the lean fertilizing is more like AD and cecum, where basically you dose depending on your plant mass. And then there's a rich style, which is estimative index, where you really dose heavy in your tank and reset at the end of the week. Or there is a kind of a hybrid type, which is what we follow at Jag Aquatics. So Jag Aquatics Pro and Starter are in between lean and rich, whereby we found a mix that where it works perfectly fine to cover all the nutrient demands of the aquatic plants. And you have to dose 3 to 4 times a week. And also you can change water up to 20 to 30%. And if you choose not to change water, it's okay. You can change the water in your regular maintenance in 2 to 3 weeks time. The other way is you can dose individual elements, which can be an example like Seachem Flourish Nitrogen or Jag Aquatics Advanced Nitrogen. The other way is through the root taps. So there are various root taps in the market from the brands like Seachem or Neo Aquatics. You can use their root taps, and this is really nice way to introduce or keep a buffer of nitrogen under the soil or under the substrate that you are using. The third and the final way is the livestock. So if you have a lot of fish in your aquarium, which definitely I would recommend, fish makes your aquarium healthy. So if you have a lot of livestock, they will also contribute through ammonia, nitrate, and nitrate, like I showed you in the first slide that we discussed. So yeah, that's the best way to achieve nitrate levels also. So these are different ways how you can fulfill the nitrogen requirement in your aquarium. Thanks guys for watching this video, and I really hope that you guys got some interesting information out of this video. And the main focus of creating this series of video is to share with you all my experiences. And not only that, I do like to discuss with you guys. So please, if I have missed anything about nitrogen, or if you guys have a different experience with different levels of nitrogen, please do comment in the comment section and we can have a good discussion there. Next video will be about phosphorus, and we will dive deep into discussing phosphorus and how it's required for the aquatic plants. Thanks for watching, and see you guys in the next video. Take care. Bye.